Welcome everyone to the DWA Civil War. Two associations will go one-on-one with one another here to determine if one or the other get to infiltrate the company. Titles will be on the line, and the 15D Boss Royal Rumble. The Civil War Rumble is upon us here from Long Beach, California. Let's get on to the show. Oh, I can't wait. Let's not waste any longer. It is time to get into our first match. Oh my goodness, and we've seen this rivalry breaking out over the past couple episodes of the D-Boss Wrestling Academy. The first match of the night, the rubber match between Timothy Castles. Look at him, check him out with that Nate t-shirt. Of course, we're all going to be kitted out in our gear today when it comes to a rivalry matchups. As Tim Castles is going to go one-on-one with his rival here. I'll see him in a minute here. And Tim Castles has been showing a brand new side of himself. He's changed his hair back to how he used to look. I found out that he didn't break down on TikTok recently. That's an old video. So the old Tim is really what Tim looks like now. But he's reverted to his old ways here in the D-Boss Wrestling Academy. Something must be up with Timothy Castles. I don't like to see it like this, and oh my goodness, he's flexing for the fans. Timothy Castle's getting fired up. All fired up! And he's coming out with those headphones now. Everyone, depending on what side you fight for, everyone is brandishing their team gear. They will have a Team Nate shirt or a Team D-Boss shirt. And you know, some guys in the back wanted to get really specific about their outfits, and here he comes. Here we go. He's been on a tear since debuting here. It's our truth. Coming out of this Team DWA gear. He has been looking menacing recently. He is making his pay-per-view debut here tonight. He is 0-for-0 here at the D-Boss Wrestling Academy pay-per-view special event shows. I wonder if he's going to keep up the undisputed streak here tonight. He has not been defeated yet. He has battled many foes. And you gotta think if he's able to keep this in line here, he's gotta be in line for some sort of, you know, title opportunity, a number one contenders match at the very least. So R-Truth's gonna be looking for a big opportunity here tonight against Tim Castles. Bury the rivalry here. The feud must come to an end here. Timothy Castles versus R-Truth. And you can hear a little Jimmy chant breaking out in the crowd. We have a raucous crowd tonight here. And here we go, R-Truth and Timothy Castles. Time to exchange some blows here. My goodness. Oh! Posting R-Truth up into the goddamn corner here. And now it's time to suffocate him. Now we have no idea who's in the Royal Rumble tonight. As we all know, 15 Nate wrestlers and 15 D-Boss wrestlers are going to be doing battle. One after another, they are going to come down to the ring and try and eliminate themselves just like that. Just like that. And this match is a tables match, folks. I forgot to mention that. That's probably a really fucking important thing to mention. This rivalry has been breaking out so far that this is going to be a tables match. Put him through a table if he's ready. Oh, and now Tim Castles tried to assert himself. Oh, God, excuse me. With that table, R-Truth not allowing any of that to happen. Gonna go to work to him now. Oh, my goodness. Some form of RKO on the outside from R-Truth. And boom, nice kick right to the back. And I've been having back problems right now. I've been sleeping wrong, you know, maybe I need to get a new mattress or something like that. But I know what back pain feels like. I know what good back pain feels like. If I was to take a kick like that, good Lord, I'd be out. As R-Truth drops an elbow right to Timothy Castles, you gotta think R-Truth is a prime position for a Royal Rumble spot tonight. I wonder who's gonna be in it. Oh my goodness. Tim Castles could very well be in it himself. We have no idea who's going to be in that match. I am again a form of D-Boss. There's a bunch of D-Bosses running around here. We got the wrestler D-Boss who will be in action tonight against Ivory. Oh, another kick to the spine against Ivory for the TikTok championship tonight. Here is going to be D-Boss, the wrestler version. GM D-Boss puts on the shows in the back here. And of course, I, commentator D-Boss, fill you guys in on what's going on here as Timothy Castles looks to dump R-Truth here with a vicious move here, but Truth able to reverse it. And it has been all R-Truth the entirety of this match, and Truth knows he needs a table. I think he's glitching out by the table. Yes, there he is. Got him. Got that table in the ring. Tim Castles is out like a light. And now R-Truth looking to set up that table. Is he going to get it set up, though? Oh, no. Couldn't beat Tim to the table. Oh, no. And now Timothy Castles. Not often do you beat a guy like Timothy Castles to the table. My goodness. And now R-Truth. Huge clothesline right now. Another clothesline from R-Truth. He's heating up. Uh-oh. Someone must have turned on the gas because R-Truth is heating up. My goodness. Getting a big barbecue scene going on right now here because R-Truth is on fire. Oh, elbows to the face. My God. Tim Castles cannot get anything going right now. And R-Truth's going to hit him with a spine buster. And he wants that table. He wants that table, but Tim's in the fucking way. Tim's fat ass AI is in the way. Truth headed to the top now. Oh my gosh, he's going to go try and drop the legs. He finally hits that. I don't think he's hit that once. Every time people have rolled out, I don't think R-Truth has hit that once, and now he's finally hitting it. And now Truth got a table set up here. We've seen him in tables matches. He defeated John Cena in a tables match on Monday Night Raw. We remember what transpired afterwards, the CM Punk pipe bomb. Incredible stuff. Hits him with the little Jimmy move. I like that. Oh no! Tim Castles tossed into the table here. Is R-Truth going to end it? Is R-Truth going to end it? Oh, he does! That's it, ladies and gentlemen! A valiant effort from Timothy Castles. Actually, I'm not even sure if I can say that. R-Truth just manhandled Tim Castles at the end of their rivalry here tonight. Winning in prime fashion here at Civil War is R-Truth. And that puts D-Boss up high against Team Nate. You're going to have to think that's going to be a favor of my team going into the Royal Rumble here. Nate's going to have to watch out. R-Truth has won. Oh, phenomenal matchup that was. Yes, indeed. R-Truth coming out incredibly on top. And ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for the Discord Championship ladder match. Above me, you can see the Discord champion strapped to whatever the hell that thing is holding it up in the air. Some sort of rope, I would assume. And now these two are going to do battle for it. Here he comes. It is Mr. Money in the Bank time. Quaddy Goon's all about his money, and soon he hopes to be all about his gold as he looks to win the Discord Championship from Brenda. Now, he has yet to cash in that Money in the Bank briefcase, so he could potentially win the Discord Championship tonight and then later on cash in on Adam Sandler to win the D-Boss Championship and become a dual champion. All he's got to do is climb the ropes, climb the ladders here, as he's done before, as he's done undefeated. Quaddy Goon has yet to lose a ladder match. But someone who has yet to lose a match since winning this championship is on the way down to the arena here. Here we go. Here we go. Here comes the Discord champion. It's Queen Brenda. King of the Ring winner. Normally she's just walking down with her title in hand. Of course, now we know it sits high above the arena, strapped up, suspended in the air, and Queen Brenda is going to look to climb to the top, retrieve her title, and make her way down to the floor again. But Quaddy Goon has just never been defeated in ladder matches. But Brenda is on a hot streak right now. If anyone is going to put a stop to Quaddy Goon's ladder streak, it's going to be Brenda right now. Of course, he won the Money in the Bank, and then he won a ladder match qualifying match. A ladder qualifying match, Jesus, to get into this match right here. There you can see the championship, Brenda's titles. Brenda's side plates right there on the goddamn championship. I told you they were there. The Discord champion. Who is it going to be? Quaddy Goon or Brenda? As you can see, they don't have any Team DWA or Team Nate gear. They're both D-Boss wrestlers, so they don't need any gear tonight. Bang! Brenda going straight at Quaddy Goon. And now anyone in the Royal Rumble will have Team DWA or Team Nate official gear. Of course, you can find that on DWAshop.net or .com, whatever the fake website was from last episode, as Brenda now heads to the top. Quaddy Goon, too agile for her. And there's no pinfalls, no submissions, no countouts, no disqualifications, no nothing like that. The only possible shot of victory you have is by grabbing that ladder and ripping that briefcase down. Normally it's a briefcase, but tonight it's a title. And Quaddy Goon's going to look to do the same. Lots of room on the outside tonight as Brenda unloads a right on Quadir. Mr. Money in the Bank. Quaddy Goon's been on a win streak. We hadn't seen him recently up until the end there where he qualified for this matchup. Quaddy Goon been on a little bit of a break after winning that Money in the Bank briefcase. He's been taunting champions, though. Just the fact that he's out there with it and hasn't done anything, he hasn't said anything. But he borderline knows that they're all out there. All those champions are out there. Quaddy Goon heads to the top. Brenda did the work for him, and he's going to scamper up to the top. Brenda going to put in some fists on Quaddy. Oh, my goodness. Brenda just not having any of this. Don't you fucking touch my championship. As she unloads a powerbomb to Quaddy Goon. Rips him off the ladder. Quaddy immediately up here. We have yet to see any championships change hands here in the DWA. Adam Sandler won the Royal Rumble to win the DWA title. Has yet to give it up. Brenda, Queen of the Ring, King of the Ring, won the King of the Ring Championship tournament to win that Discord title. Defended against Boy, has yet to lose it. The Salvatore brothers won the tag team title tournaments. Have yet to give that up. They've faced Uncle Roy. Oh, and Lightning McQueen as Quaddy Goon unloads on Brenda. They faced them twice tonight. I believe this is going to be the last time they will meet each other. And Brenda is bleeding right into the ladder. This is not looking good for Queen Brenda as Quaddy Goon is now wearing her down. This is just what he wants, going into work on that arm. She's going to need that to get the goddamn briefcase down. And now Quaddy Goon putting in some serious punishment. Kick straight to the gut of Brenda. And now Quadir is headed to the top. BBG Quaddy Goon. Mr. Money in the Bank. Oh, no! Like a battering ram just charging at Brenda from the top rope. And Quaddy Goon looks unload on Brenda. Didn't know what to do there, whether to go to the top or unload. And Brenda, like a spry fox, like a gamble park fox, is just up like that. Oh, no! Quaddy Goon! Oh, no! Terrible stuff from Quaddy. Oh, my God. Brenda is in a world of trouble right now as Quaddy Goon just punishes the back. You know Brenda can't take much punishment like that.
No Quaddy Goon.
Oh my God, that's terrible. Such dirty tactics from Quadir. And he is just not letting Brenda get any offense in. This is just so stressful to watch for these fans right in that front row there. Brenda mounting no offense right now as Quaddy Goon just thoroughly puts himself in charge of the Discord champion here. And now he's got her on the sides here. Oh, no. I don't like this, Quaddy. Oh, I don't like this. Nailing her. Oh, no. No, no, no. This is terrible! That's concrete, as you can see. My goodness. We spared no services tonight. All med staff are in the back, as you can see. We have a goddamn concrete arena here. And Brenda, a little bit of a slap to Quaddy Goon. Brenda into the ring. Brenda up to the top of the ladder here. She'd like to get a grip on her championship. Could be the last time she ever touches that championship, depending on how Quaddy Goon's able to fare right now. And Brenda in some trouble. Oh, wait a minute. Why is Quaddy Goon the one bleeding on the side of his head? Brenda's not bleeding. Quaddy Goon is bleeding. I thought Brenda was bleeding. She ran into the ladder. She must have caught him with an elbow or something like that. And it is all Quaddy Goon. And we know what happens when it's all one-sided here. R-Truth just dominated Tim Castles in that last match, and it was no contest. We are almost at the 7-minute mark, I believe, of this matchup. Maybe the 6-minute mark, something like that. I could be wrong. But Quaddy Goon and Brenda, this is looking seriously devastating for Brenda. And now Quaddy Goon. Quaddy Goon. Oh, wait. Fight left in Brenda. Some fight left in Brenda. Still alive is Brenda. Queen Brenda is not just going to let her championship slide like that. Oh my goodness. Huge neckbreaker from Brenda as she kicks Quaddy Goon right in the gut. And now Brenda headed to the top. Are we going to see it? Are we going to see it? The Brenda splash. No, Quaddy with the legs up. Quaddy gets the knees up and now he's headed to the top for that championship. And Brenda with the forearms right up at him. She wants him off that belt. Oh no. The Brenda splash just missed, and Brenda's going to drop him with another powerbomb. Queen Brenda. What's the plan here? Is she looking to get back up top? What's the plan here? I think the AI was having a little bit of a glitch fest there. Brenda rolling him up. Huge super kick to the face of Quaddy Goon, and Brenda is up to the top. Could this be what the Queen needed? Uh-oh. She's getting some serious damage in on that briefcase right now, on the championship. Keep calling it a briefcase because I'm used to the Money in the Bank ladder match. Brenda is in serious charge right now. Kwadi Goon back to his feet. This could be detrimental to Brenda getting all this work done on those notches. Trying to get those straps on the belt unhooked. And now that might come into play here for Kwadi Goon. If Brenda's not able to get up here, Kwadi Goon could take advantage. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no! I think he just hit her with the Chirac drop, and now Kwadi Goon. Wait a minute. Reversal from Brenda to the back of the kneecap here. Brenda still in charge. Brenda still alive here. Reversing Kwadi Goon. Oh, huge kick to the face of Kwadi Goon. It's been a while since we've seen a Kwadi Goon loss. Quite a while. And here comes that Brenda splash! Oh my goodness, out of nowhere! The Brenda splash. Is the Queen gonna retain? Is tonight... Wait a minute! Oh my goodness, she's got something else planned from the top of the ladder! Oh! What have I just seen? And she's tuning it up. Brenda tuning up the super kick. The This Is Awesome chant is breaking out now as the Queen of the Ring, Brenda, now heads to the top to retrieve what's rightfully hers. The reign of Queen Brenda is not over yet, but uh-oh, like a prowler, like a thief in the night, Kwadi Goon. Oh no. She may have just wasted a little too much time with that super kick there. And now Kwadi Goon. Dreadful stuff could be happening right now. And Brenda up to her knees here. Brenda up to her feet. Kwadi Goon will spare no minutes here. Oh no. Oh no, Kwadi Goon with those forearms. Brenda unloading some. I think we're going to see a couple exchanged blows now here. Oh no! Kwadi Goon, head right to the... Head smash to the ladder. Oh no! Kwadi, you can't do this! Oh no! Brenda's out cold! Ladies and gentlemen, Brenda's out cold! Kwadi's to the top! The crowd chanting for one more time, ladies and gentlemen. Is Kwadi Goon going to steal the Discord World Championship? He's trying to strip that belt from the top. He's so close. He can taste it. And ladies and gentlemen... Oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen, I can't believe what I'm seeing. After everything that just happened, we have a new... Discord World Champion. Kwadi Goon remains undefeated in ladder matches, and here is your new Discord World Champion, Kwadi Goon. Ladies and gentlemen, we are coming live to you in the ring here with Harry from the Sidemen. And I just want to confirm to you that this is a battle royale, an 8-man battle royale. An 8-man Sidemen battle royale. We have got all the Sidemen in the ring coming out here. And who's coming out next? We've got Harry. Vic Starr came out. KSI was out there. Here he is. It's Simon. My goodness, that's Simon from the Sidemen. They're all out there. They're all fucking out there. They're actually all out here. Mini Minters coming down to the ring here. Now, there's only seven Sidemen, but there's an eighth out here. All of them are about to come here and do battle in the ring here. They're all under contract, but I've never used them here. And I need to make up room, so only one of them will get to stay. Oh my god, he just scared me. He just slapped the, shit out of those stairs. He scared the shit out of me. I'm gonna be uploading all of them and then deleting all of them except the winner of this match because I need more room for new guys. And you'll see why. There you see Vic Starr, Zerka, and Harry in the back there. Who else is coming out there?
Vic Star in the back.
You know who is this? Oh my goodness! It's Toby! Toby from the Sidemen. I don't know much about some of these Sidemen guys. I just know about like a couple of their videos. I watch like a few Sidemen videos of Nate every now and then. And that's about as far as my Sidemen knowledge goes. And yet here I have all of them in the WWE game. Goes to show where my priorities are at as Toby from the Sidemen. All kitted out in Sidemen gear coming out here. Oh my goodness, he's flexing hard.
I can't wait to see who wins this matchup.
There's a couple of them. Who's, and I believe we're waiting for one more guy. Who's this gonna be here? Wait a minute, I know this music. I know this music anywhere! Uh-oh! There he is! The former DWA Tag Team Champion of the bygone era, of course. It's Steven Tries, him and Mong Smith at the Halloween special of the first rendition of the DWA. Won the DWA Tag Team Championship from the Mario Brothers, while Filthy Frank and Pink Guy were all in that match as well. Filthy Frank and Pink Guy, no sign of them thus far in the Next Generation. Have yet to see them. We don't know if we'll see them, but Steven Tries and Mong Smith have recently made their returns. Of course, they're Nate guys through and through, so that's why they've probably made their returns. And they were actually in a tag match to win the tag title, number one contender opportunity, until Boy and Lightning McQueen took care of that. And here we go. There's Vic Star and Harry. There's Zerka and Toby. There's KSI. We've seen him win a battle royale before already. There's Simon and Ethan and Steven Tries. Oh my goodness. Absolutely decking them up. All eight of them are in the ring here. And the question is, which one of them is going to have a career here at some point? I can't have all of them. They take up fucking seven spots. That's a full tenth. Oh, that's almost a full tenth, and there goes Toby! My goodness, Zerka eliminates Toby. That's terrifying stuff. Vic Star is still out there. Steven Tries, huge foot right to the face of Harry. And if I'm a betting man, I'm going to bet that my guy Nate wants Harry to win this match. He's a big Harry fan. Me, personally, I would love to see Steven Tries win this match as Ethan now going to work on Zerka. And before this matchup started, of course, we saw the dethroning of Queen Brenda as Quaddy Goon is the brand new Discord champion. Beat her in a ladder match for the Discord championship. Nice backflip from Harry. I still can't believe my eyes, man. Brenda did so much work. And Harry! Oh my god, he's over the top rope and he kicked Vixar right in the face. Not yet out for Harry. Nate was probably chewing on his fingernails for that one right there. As Ethan is in some trouble here. Simon, reversal from Ethan. And Zerka making his presence known over there. He's just walking around. KSI on the floor. I think we need to get rid of KSI. He's already had a DWA World Championship opportunity. Lost that match to Adam Sandler. And Simon absolutely punching fucking Ethan right in the face. Yeah, man, I can't believe Quaddy Goon is the new Discord World Champion. And Zerka, my goodness, he's just been thrown over by KSI. I don't think we're getting KSI over anytime soon. He did that to Toby, and that's the same way he's going to. Just terrible, KSI eliminating him. And look at Steven Tries in a world of trouble. There goes Harry. Steven Tries eliminated Harry. Oh, my goodness, Nate, Harry is gone. Vic Star kicked in the face. He's still out there. Simon's out there. Ethan is out there. KSI still alive. Who the fuck is going to win this match? Ethan's over the top. And Simon trying to pick him off. He just missed, bro. He just missed again. He couldn't wring the fingers right there. And now Vic Star finally making his presence felt. Nice leg hook suplex. Steven Tries over there with Ethan. Uh-oh. What the fuck was that from Steven Tries? Oh my god, this is an insane matchup right now. I didn't think these guys would be the final five. I honestly hoped Harry would go a little farther, I can't even lie. But whatever, Simon, Mini Mint are going off right now. And these guys
have some seriously funny videos. There's that gruesome knee just nails KSI in the fucking head.
And oh my god, he was looking to line up a super kick, but then he just hits him with a fist. And it's all Simon right now. It is all Simon. And look at Steven. Steven tries in some trouble now as Simon just does some insane move. Now, these guys have had some seriously funny videos. There was the goddamn... Oh, my goodness, there goes Ethan playing over the top. KSI eliminates Ethan. We are down to Steven tries Vic Star, Simon, and KSI. One of these men is going to win the Sidemen Battle Royal. Simon, what the fuck is this, Simon? Oh, no. Oh, no. Vic Star! Vic Star's over the top. Down to Simon, KSI, and Steven tries. Oh no, and Simon in some serious trouble. What a showing from Simon tonight. He hasn't eliminated anyone, but he's been cutting in, and Steven tries, has eliminated someone. And he is not cutting in now. KSI caught him like that. Reversal. Oh, and catches him with the elbow, and then a monster meat hook clothesline from KSI, just taking him down, and Steven tries in some serious trouble here. Oh my goodness Christ. KSI. Oh no! KSI! KSI! Oh! Leaving him out on the clothesline to try, and there's a spear from KSI! Oh my goodness! Taking over, and Simon is in serious trouble now. Oh my goodness. And how are you guys enjoying the pay-per-view at home? I hope you guys are enjoying the event. Of course, we still have lots more to come. We've got the Tag Team Championship match between Lightning McQueen and Uncle Roy, Team Ka-Chow versus the Salvatore Brothers. Of course, the DWA Championship match, Custom Grow versus Adam Sandler. And then, at the very end of it all, the main event, the Civil War Royal Rumble, where if a Nate character is to win, they will all enter the DWA. And if a D-Boss wrestler is to win, they will all be banished from the DWA. So I wonder how this is going to turn out. Can't wait to see it as Simon absolutely unloading. Oh my goodness. Steven tries underhook suplex. Steven tries is being eliminated. Now we'll have to see if we don't, we'll have to see if we see Steven tries again, because of course, although we might need to free up more space, he does have a tag team with Mong Smith still around. So he might need to win this as KSI just unloaded on Miniman King. Simon in trouble, rolling out of harm's way, kicked right to the gut. KSI goes down with a hard blow to the head from Simon. Now we do remember the 20v1 KSI video. Simon had his opportunity to say yes to KSI, and he walked away. So you gotta think there's some bad blood right here as the knee's coming out, unloading him right in the middle of the arena. There's Mini Minter. Now Steven tries, goes down. I think there's some blood out there on the arena. Yes, there is. Not the first time we've seen bloodshed. Quaddy Goon bled a little bit in that matchup for the Discord Championship, but it turned out his efforts bore fruit, as he is now your new Discord Champion, and you gotta think Brenda's gonna wanna cash in a rematch for that. My goodness. And look at this. KSI goes down incredibly hard. Mini Minter is in charge right now, everyone. I wonder how this matchup's gonna turn out. Oh my goodness! Oh no, that's a gruesome powerbomb right there from KSI, man. How the fuck is this still going on? Yeah, okay. Bro, there's three of you guys. Throw them out. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. KSI. Okay, I guess he's taking what I said quite literally as Simon is thrown over the top into the floor. We're down to Steven. Tries! Hits him with a huge elbow. This could be the turning of the tides here for Steven Tries. Maybe he was just waiting for KSI to put it away, and oh my goodness, a skull crushing finale from absolute nowhere. Oh no, but KSI from a reversal from absolutely nowhere, and oh no, not this flipping slam right there, right to the back of the head. That's gotta hurt. A little bit of whiplash. Steven tries on a spear from KSI, and I think KSI is looking to put the finishing touches on this match right now. Oh no. Oh no, leaving him out on the clothesline to dry. See, this is the part of the match where you pick him up and throw him over, because otherwise something like that could happen. Steven tries back up in it, looking to throw out KSI potentially here. He's got him in the corner, and there's some bloodshed here from KSI now. Looking deadly. Steven tries, kick to the gut, reversing it. Oh my god, who's going to win this match? KSI with a reversal. More reversals, man. Uh-oh. Steven tries, knees to the gut from Steven tries from KSI, and then he's just dispatching him over to the right. Oh no! I think at this point, my money has to be on Steven Tries. You can see the blood pouring from KSI's face. I mean, how is this man going to win this matchup with all that blood? Oh, wait a minute here. He could... Oh, wait. Oh, no, no. Elbows. I think these guys are literally fighting on fumes right now. They're just trying to reverse everything, give it all they have. All the energy they have left is coming out right now. These guys just are not stopped. They're both relentless at the same time. It's devastating stuff. I didn't think this would actually be that good of a matchup. And Steven Tries in some serious trouble now. That could just be the tides changing right now for KSI. And Steven Tries hits the floor. It's over. KSI actually won that matchup after all the damage, all the blood pouring from his face. After everything, we now know who the definitive sideman is of the group. All eight of them participated, and KSI is the last man standing. He wins the Sidemen Battle Royal, and we shall see more of him down the line. Good win, man. That's a seriously good win. KSI. Well, during the Sidemen Battle Royale, we are talking about championships that were going to be on the line, and I neglected to mention one specific championship because that was coming up next, and it is the first interpromotional championship match. This matchup is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the TikTok World Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, here he comes. It's me. It's D-Boss. Oh no, I can't believe it. Rocking a new attire out here. Here comes wrestler version D-Boss. Oh no. Team DWA branded all on the gear. You know this man is fully intact right now. And he won a battle royale against a bunch of Nate guys, a bunch of D-Boss guys to become the number one contender for this match. A lot of people said it was a fluke. Boy specifically said it was a fluke. But yet here he is, competing at the Civil War in a one-on-one match against the champion for the TikTok Championship. He won the right to be here, so by God damn it, he will be here as D-Boss. More like Bob Ross enters the arena, and here comes his opponent. And his opponent is a very devastating man. His opponent is never to be messed with. His opponent is never to be taken lightly. And D-Boss knows this because he is lost in great fashion to this man. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the TikTok World Champion. It's Ivory. Ivory McGregor Samoa. You can find him on TikTok if you look that up. And he is coming out here with a new lay. He's got a blue lay on. He's got the Team Nate branding on his outfit. Of course, he's not wearing a shirt. Most guys have just come out here wearing new shirts and such. But Ivory, no. He's got his own pants. The TikTok World Champ from the Nate side of things. Now, this is not an officially recognized DWA World Championship, but as always, if Ivory's willing to put it up on the line against the D-Boss guy to bring it into the company, I will always sign that matchup. So here he comes here. Do you think he will be able to defend properly against myself tonight as he hits the ring here? Look at how devastating that man is. He is so terrifying. And they still need to get the shorts right in this goddamn game as Ivory unloading on the crowd, letting them bask in his glory. And you know they're a fan of him. You know they're a huge fan of Ivory around these parts. Even though he's a villain, he's a terrible man. He's invading your company, and you still cheer him. He's invading here right now. Literally invading here right now. Anyways, that's all we can say at this moment. The time for talking is over. It's time for the main event. Feeling like Mark Henry out here right now at AEW, you know. Anyways, here we go. That's what it's all about, the TikTok Championship. In the corner over here to my left, representing Team DWA, the one, the only, D-Boss. And the crowd cheering for him still. To my right, representing Team Nate, he is the TikTok champion, the legend, the Australian behemoth, the defending champ, the undisputed Ivory. You see him holding up the championship. Still, that may be the last time he ever touches that belt, depending on how D-Boss is able to wrestle here tonight. He's going to put it on his strap one more time there. He's going to take one look at it. Now, he represents TikTok heavily. This man loves his TikTok. Me? I don't fucking use it. Unless it's to send cool-looking memes and such to Nate or Sham or, you know, anyone. My boy sometimes. Not really, though, because he doesn't really use it that much either. So let's see how this is going to go. This could be an absolute... This could be an absolute disrespect to Ivory if I was to win this championship here. These two have met in the ring before. Ivory, I'm not afraid to say it, manhandled me at the D-Boss Wrestling Academy. Oh my goodness! And it looks like he's picking up where he left off. Oh my goodness, aggressive rights right to my fucking face. And now, oh no, this is not a man you want to see at the top rope. He's looking to end this immediately. Oh my goodness. He's looking to squash me. And now Ivory. Oh, no! How am I up immediately from that? I can't believe I'm up immediately from that. But Ivory with the reversal. Gonna look to unload now. Oh, no. Oh, no! Just hurling me on the ropes. My God. No regard whatsoever. Could have injured me and right back to the rights. This is a mugging. This is an absolute mugging. This is a street fight right now. Ivory came for a fucking street fight. Now D-Boss gonna give it to him. Oh my goodness, going right at that arm there. He's gonna go right back to the arm. They love going at the arm two or three times. Unloading at Ivory. Pick that bitch up. But the TikTok champ, so versatile. Oh my goodness! A man like that is not supposed to be that agile. A man like that is not supposed to be that vicious. Oh no, and the Cobra Clutch on D-Boss. Is he gonna tap out? Is that enough? Oh no! The willpower. D-Boss still fighting it. Yes, sir, here we go. You know my type are super strong. My people are super strong. Of course, I am commentator D-Boss. If you're just checking in, the TikTok championship is on the line right now. Wrestler D-Boss in there representing us. Not only the team DWA, but also us D-Boss kind here. I am commentator D-Boss, GM D-Boss, putting on the show here. Unfortunately, all of us have to sit here and watch Ivory just unloading on wrestler D-Boss right now. He is getting the work put in. Hold on a minute here. Still alive. D-Boss is still alive. Oh, no. Oh, no. I think Ivory just caught him. Oh, no. Slamming him down with a powerbomb. Ref right into the cover. That's one. That's two, and I'm still out. D-Boss still out of the cover here at two. Oh, Jesus Christ, he's lining me up now. Ivory wants to put this away immediately. Oh, no, this can't be. No, not like this. I think it's safe to say that Ivory has officially had enough of D-Boss for the second time. Ivory unloads. No, he's out. He's out right at the last second. Everyone has their hearts in pieces at the moment. Everyone's at a standstill. They can't believe I'm still in there. As the Fight Forever chant rings out now. D-Boss still showing signs of life here. Big DDT to change the tides of things. Here we go. Can we unload? Can we pick up a crucial victory and bring the TikTok championship to the D-Boss Wrestling Academy? Here we go. Brandishing some John Cena type moves. Hit him with that little bit of hold up a minute. Five knuckle shuffle. Here we go. Here we go. Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness! Hits him with the attitude adjustment. Or the FU. That's one. Could that be it? Oh, the championship stays in the balance right now. And Ivory right at D-Boss. What agility right now. Are you kidding me right now? How is this guy unloading these moves? The hooks. The left hooks. The elbows. Ivory is doing everything in his power. I think he was stunned by D-Boss. He didn't expect me to unload something like that on him. Here we... Oh, hold on a minute here. D-Boss still alive. Oh! Oh, no! My goodness! Like a freight train running into a bystander. Oh, but D-Boss still out. I can't believe it. Ivory can't believe it. The ref can't believe it. The dudes in the front row, that guy with the Finn Balor shirt can't believe it right now. Oh, no! Oh no, here it comes. No! The Samoan drop. Ivory's rendition of the Samoan drop, and the TikTok champion remains. That's horrifying stuff. D-Boss gets put down. The TikTok championship remains in the grasp of the Nate Wrestling Group. Oh my goodness, Ivory retains his championship. The TikTok champ is still Ivory. He's going to celebrate at the top of the rope. And you have to think, if the Nate's crew is able to win the Royal Rumble, what kind of shenanigans will ensue? Well, we are nearing our main event, Civil War Royal Rumble, still to come. 15 Nate guys and 15 D-Boss guys will do battle in a Royal Rumble style match. But before then, we've got tag team action coming up. Here they come. Looked at as underdogs in this matchup, and this is very much a lot of people. A lot of people on social media have been saying this is one of the last opportunities Uncle Roy should get at some sort of gold until he proves he can earn it. But in my opinion, he earns it every time whenever I put him in those matches, and he earns the opportunity to get there. He just doesn't win in the end. It's fucked. And Uncle Roy can completely feel it. He's got the Team DWA diaper on right now. Lightning McQueen still rocking that Among Us guy. And this is a milestone moment in the careers of both Lightning McQueen and Big Boy Uncle Roy, because this is for the Tag Team Championships. If they can't prove that they can beat the Damon Salvatore and if they can't prove that they can beat the Salvatore brothers together tonight, where does this tag team go in the future? Because they've both beaten these characters, one on their own, and oh my goodness, look at this. Look at this. It's the Salvatore brothers. Oh my goodness, and they're both wearing Team Nate shirts. They've finally shown where their allegiance lies. So it's official. This is a DWA versus Nate matchup here. This is an interpromotional Civil War matchup. Does this mean that even the tag championships don't even belong to us anymore? They never have. Oh my goodness. The stakes have just grown that much higher for Team Kachow to win these championships. They need to prove that as a team together, they can beat the Salvatore brothers, Damon and Stefan Salvatore. We know that beatdown Stefan had against Uncle Roy. We've seen Lightning McQueen beat them both at the same time, 2-on-1. Uncle Roy got his revenge on Stefan Salvatore in a sanctioned matchup. Lightning McQueen beat Damon Salvatore. This is a long-going rivalry. The Salvatore brothers and Team Kachow will not forget one another after tonight here as their last encounter for the YouTube World Tag Team Championships begins. That's what it's all about. You can see there their side plates, the Vampire Diaries logo. Here we have it. Representing Team DWA, Lightning McQueen and Big Boy Uncle Roy. Representing Team Nate, they are the YouTube World Tag Champs, Damon and Stefan Salvatore. And the ref's going to remove those straps from their possession. There we go. Thank you, boys. That's what it's all about. The Tag Championships. Who is the dominant tag team faction? We're gonna get things kicked off with Uncle Roy and Stefan Salvatore, the rematch. Here we go. You know Uncle Roy's been waiting to get his hands on this guy again. Oh my goodness, he just misses that kick, and now Stefan is gonna take charge here. There's another kick. That's how you get a kick done there. And now Stefan starting to unload. This is where it begins, man. This is where it all begins. Stefan Salvatore with those kicks. It was a gruesome beatdown in a tag team matchup scheduled on the DWA Academy regular house shows. And Stefan Salvatore dispatched Uncle Roy out of the ring after he broke up a pinfall attempt. And then the beatdown just ensued. The world famous beatdown ensued. And now this rivalry has just heated up to 10 times what it was. And now Uncle Roy, oh my goodness, unloading that buzzsaw kick right to Damon Salvatore. And look at this. I'm sorry, I messed it up there because the big man, Lightning McQueen, checking in. Oh my goodness! Thought a huge powerbomb was coming up on Lightning. Stefan or Damon rolling him up. Stefan enters the ring just to make sure everything's good. Lightning quick reflexes. No pun intended. Lightning with the lightning quick reflexes. And now Stefan or Damon. I keep getting their names mixed up because of that brawl, man. I just have that brawl ingrained in my mind. So now Stefan Salvatore, for me, is the more prominent brother. Because of that beatdown, but Damon Salvatore Make no mistake about it, not to be undermined here as he works Lightning McQueen over to the corner. But here he comes, the younger, spry Salvatore brother, Stefan. And I have to announce that Nate corrected me on this. I used to think that these guys were like 1,000 years old, mystical creatures. Lightning McQueen just tagged in. I didn't even see that Uncle Roy. Oh my god, he was trying to break him off. I didn't even see. I don't even think Uncle Roy was ready for that. Oh no, there's that huge knee that we saw over on the outside. That's what came through in that beatdown, man. Yeah, Nate informed me that these guys are only like 100 years old, so they're just chilling. They're rookie vampires, bro. Uncle Roy heard that shit, and he was like, 100? Oh, fuck. Are you kidding me? These guys beat us the first time? As he worked away at Uncle Roy's back. Uncle Roy was seeming pretty confident coming into this. A nice gruesome kick there. Uncle Roy looking to fight back, but Stefan Salvatore, my god. Oh my goodness. And he wants no more part of Boy. He doesn't want any more part of him. But I'm sure Boy wouldn't mind having the older Salvatore brother as he works away some chops and some fists at Uncle Roy. Oh no. For the tag championship, Uncle Roy can't afford to lose this again as Lightning McQueen tags in. Damon Salvatore in serious trouble. No, wait. He's actually going to get that axe handle off. Uncle Roy reversing it. Some moves. Oh my goodness. Uncle Roy looking to swing things in Lightning McQueen's favor. Oh my goodness. The interference from Uncle Roy. He's going to have to get out before the ref counts him for DQ. There is a disqualification. If you tag out, you can only remain in the ring for a 5 count. And if you're still in there, the ref's going to fuck you over and pull the match. Lightning McQueen, we don't want to see a big man like that go up that high! As he brings down the axe handle onto the back. And look at him! Just struggle! Struggle lift this guy up! And flip him, that was just pure strength. That was just pure strength, oh my goodness! We're gonna need medical out here soon! As Lightning is just unloading on Damon Salvatore, but wait a minute, look at the strength. The quickness of the vampire brother, Damon Salvatore. But wait a minute, Lightning's still in this. Oh my goodness, Damon. Oh my god, he's on his feet. He landed on his feet in Lightning McQueen. That's unheard of. A huge suplex to Lightning McQueen. There's no possible way. Fists from Lightning. Oh no. Oh no, this could prove deadly. Right in front of his brother. Leaving him out on the clothesline. Leaving him out on the Nate-themed clothesline. Lightning McQueen with the disrespect to Team Nate. Right in front of his younger brother. Kicking him in the nuts. And here comes the ringleader. Here comes the grandmaster. It's Uncle Roy, the mastermind of this team. Oh, just going to work after the damage has been done. Lightning McQueen set him up. Wait a minute here. Oh my goodness! A full diaper from the top rope right to the face. Stefan Salvatore has no choice but to watch as Uncle Roy strips them from the championships. No, he's out at two. Out at two is Damon Salvatore and Uncle Roy. Gonna go right at him with those boots. Uncle Roy wants this over and done with. He wants this over and done with. But wait a minute. Damon fighting back with some elbows. Still alive is Damon Salvatore from the Vampire Diaries. Huge underhook suplex to Uncle Roy. Turning things back in the tide of the Salvatore brothers. And look who just checked in here. He wants his hands on Uncle Roy now, it seems. Oh no! Stefan Salvatore, no. Wait a minute though. Uncle Roy seems to have his number at the moment. And things are looking up for Team Ka-Chow at the moment. Uncle Roy needs to dole out some more punishment on Stefan Salvatore here. What do we got planned? Oh, a big throwing suplex. Didn't even bother to drop himself down with him. That was no soft landing, but a nice underhook to the leg there. Gonna prove serious damage against Uncle Roy here. Oh no. Oh no. The plan here from Stefan Salvatore. No. Oh god. Ringing out the arm. You know that rope burn's gotta be painful right there. Oh, and a knee right to the face. Terrible stuff on the ref in for the cover. That's one. And Uncle Roy is out at one. Uncle Roy is out at one. You know how desperate he wants it. I think he was trying to cuss out Lightning McQueen, but he got terrified. He got shook. He got scared, and now he has to tag into his older brother here, Damon. Damon seemingly doing all the work here tonight, as Uncle Roy. Oh, no! Oh, God! Oh, Jesus Christ! Elbows right to the chest. Oh, my goodness, Uncle Roy! Serious move here, right in front of his brother. That's one! That's two for the championships! Damon is out at two. Oh, my gosh, for the championship titles. Right there, Uncle Roy almost had it, and Lightning gonna tag in here now. Oh, goodness, the big machine, the vehicle tagging in here. This is not the con. Oh, good lord. Oh, good lord. I couldn't even look there right there. Oh, he broke him open. He broke open Damon Salvatore. Things are looking bleak for the Salvatore brothers right now. But wait a minute here. Just as I say that, elbows from Damon. Nice reversal. Oh, over the body. Flipping suplex or DDT right there. No. Here comes Stefan. Now Stefan wants in at lightning. Now that he's on the floor. The coward. Now that Damon... Oh, he was trying to hit a spear. One of those Stefan spears, but the knee from lightning. Oh, no, there it is. There's the ka-chow. Oh, my God. My goodness. For the championships. 1-2-0. Damon able to come in and break it up. Lightning McQueen not a fan of any of this. And the tag team wrestling champs. Oh my goodness! Taking out the trash is Lightning McQueen. And now he's going to look to submit Stefan Salvatore here. Lightning McQueen going to try and win the tag championships. Never a better time than before. Oh my goodness. Stefan out of harm's way though. Serious trouble. Lightning got him up though. Oh! My goodness. Knees right to the sternum and just dropping him. And what's the plan for Lightning? Is he going to look to tag in his tag team partner? No. Oh my goodness! Another ka-chow! And that is going to be it! The tag titles have changed! Uncle Roy dispatches Damon Salvatore! That's it! Another title changes hands here! Ladies and gentlemen, after all the struggles and hardships Uncle Roy has gone through, Lightning McQueen standing by his side as he wins gold here tonight. Team Ka-Chow is your new tag team champions. They are able to finally dispatch of the Salvatore brothers. And now Uncle Roy is finally able to celebrate with his partner and his championship gold. What a win for Team Ka-Chow. Your new championships. The DWA brings it home. Well, it's come to this. We have two more matches on tap. And before we get into the Civil War Royal Rumble, we must know who will walk out of here as the D-Boss Wrestling Academy World Champion. This match is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the World Heavyweight Championship of the D-Boss Wrestling Academy. Here comes the challenger. And we've seen this man in these kind of matches before. He participated in the very first ever WrestleMania we ever held. In the main event, he defended against Dr. Disrespect the once World Heavyweight Championship. And it was Dooley who cashed in his Money in the Bank briefcase in the main event and won the championship. And we have yet to see Custom Grow return to his championship form until tonight, where he challenges Adam Sandler right now for that championship. Here we go, Custom Grow brandishing his Team DWA outfit. Good stuff for him. My goodness. And here comes his opponent. The man who represents our company. The man who put us on his back. Here he is. The winner of the Royal Rumble. The man who has still yet to miss a rumble. It's Adam Sandler, the D-Boss Wrestling Academy champion. My goodness. The champ is in the building and he is set to compete against Custom Grow. Now he has defended against Vince. He's defended against Big Jovis. He's matched up with Kermit, Steve Harrington, all sorts. But he's never gone one-on-one with another legend of his status, like Custom Grow. Both Custom Grow and Adam Sandler are both legends in the arena. Both of them were in the first Royal Rumble. Both of them have seen world championship runs. It is only natural that they meet in the ring for the first time now, one-on-one. I can't believe it. We're gonna run over here. Discuss this here. That's what it's all about. The World Heavyweight Championship of the D-Boss Wrestling Academy. Here we go. This match is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the D-Boss Wrestling Academy. Here to my left, the challenger, Custom Grow 420. He is fucking fiending. He's looking like a beast.
Will he be able to win this championship tonight? On the other side of me is the champion. He is the former winner of the Royal Rumble. The man who's never missed one. He is your DWA World Champion, Adam Sandler. There he is, the champion, the world champion.
The ref's going to strut on. We've seen him do this a couple times tonight.
The ref strutting on over and stripping the champion of his belt, showing off CG. That's what it's all about, brother. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, crowd, this is what it's all about. He's going to show us the championship. Here we go. You see the belt. You see the money. I see the shoes. Custom Grow. Adam Sandler. The time for talking is over. The DWA champion is on the line here.
Championship is on the line here. My God, and Adam Sandler. A clubbing lariat. A clubbing clothesline. Oh, my goodness. And now CD trying to drop in on Adam Sandler. Not going to have any of that. You know he's not going to have any of that. And Adam Sandler
with the right. Flying forearms from Sandler. Custom Grow just walking out of harm's way. And now he's going to pay attention to the knees. Got to pay attention to those Sandler knees as CG drops the splash in.
And Custom Grow, it's been so long since he's been in a championship opportunity here. Adam Sandler is going to be sure to make sure he makes him work for it as he works in on the palms, bro. The palms, the Adam Sandler palms. Oh, this chair is not good right now as a knee just explodes out onto Custom Grow's face. And another knee. Adam Sandler is here for ferocity. He is fighting at high velocity right now. And Adam Sandler drops a big knee on Custom Grow. Oh, and a moonsault. And it is all Sandler right now as Custom Grow needs to fight in here. Oh, no. The ref in for the count. He's down at two and Custom Grow kicks out. What would you have done if Custom Grow did not kick out with that? I'd have been horrified. And CG, Sandler catches him, hits him with a knee and a kick to the head. This is not looking good for Custom Grow, everyone. This is looking dire for CG.
As Sandler just puts in the extra effort here on Custom Grow. Oh my goodness. Knees. Oh my God. Adam Sandler just losing all control here. Oh no. Custom Grow, huge headbutt right to Sandler. That's what I like to see. A little bit of a glitch right there. Don't worry about any of that, though.
We're not here to pay attention to any of that.
We're here to watch Sandler and Custom Grow go at it. And, you know, the first WrestleMania, Custom Grow entered as the World Heavyweight Champion. Can you believe how long it's been since then? And now here we are. Finally. It has been so long since then, and now Custom Grow is finally getting an opportunity at his championship once more. He never got to take on Dooley for his championship. He never got that rematch before the rebranding happened. Took a big hiatus and then the rebranding happened. And now here we are, Custom Grow getting absolutely worked over by Sandler. Weirdly enough, Dooley is nowhere to be seen. And now he must compete against Sandler, who's looking on Lotus finishing maneuver here. Oh my goodness, we're going to see it. No, wait a minute here. Wait a minute here. CG doesn't want to see any of that. Now he's in for the cover. A sneak pin on Sandler. That's two. Sandler's out at two. CG horrified. It's going to take a lot more than that, bro. Lot more than that to take out Sandler. Oh, you got to be smarter than that, CG. And you got to be quicker than that to get Sandler out of there. Oh, wait a minute here. May have had a little bit of trouble from Sand19 here as CG. My goodness, why am I yawning? Now, and there's a spear unloaded from CG. He just dropped that off the pool right there. Is that going to be enough? The championship! No! Out at two, Sandler able to retain the championship. Stay in the balance. He didn't retain yet. And CG dropping the knee on Sandler and wringing him out like a dirty old rag. My God. That's not what the crowd wants to see. Terrible stuff. And now CG flexing hard on Adam Sandler. Could we finally see the world championship change hands? We have never seen a champion that isn't Adam Sandler yet. The Royal Rumble is where we got kicked off. It was for the championship and he won it. He has yet to let it go. And is CG able to strip it from him? After all the work he's just put in, Custom Grow is now undoing all of it. Right here, right now. Sandler is down, oh my goodness! Oh my goodness, what the fuck did I just see? Oh my goodness. I can't believe it. The crowd can't believe it. We're all stunned.
Sandler is down in Custom Grow. Just won the world championship. Oh my goodness. There's a new face of the company. And his name is Jolie Olie.